Today, I'm going to be fitting the clutch slave cylinder kit from RSR Moto. First impressions are great. It's a nicely manufactured component, and the kit includes everything you're going to need. Three new bolts, a pair of copper washers, and this little spacer for when you're using it with older bikes. I'll be fitting this to a Ducati 1992 Supersport 900. One of the characteristics of this bike is a reasonably heavy clutch lever action. And my bike's still running its original slave cylinder from 92. So let's get the bike up on a paddock stand, clear the work area, and get cracking. You're going to need a few things. Some brake fluid, a bleeding kit, some brake cleaner for any spills, and a few basic hand tools, along with the kit itself. A great tip is to remove your fairing panels, as this will not only give you better access to the work area, but it will minimise the chances of spilling any of that brake fluid on your paintwork. So with the bike clear, get the reservoir cap off. I like to mask off around this area, minimises the chances of getting any brake fluid on the paint, especially when you're topping the fluid up. Drain that old fluid out, and then you clear to remove the clutch slave cylinder that's on. Get that out of the way. And offer up the new part. And don't forget the rubber gasket behind. This needs to be fitted. It'll keep any dirt out of the way. And then you can loosely bolt up the new part. Good opportunity to check whether you've got that spacer in there if it's required before you go too much further. Using the new copper washers, tighten down the banjo. And then we're ready to connect the bleeder up and get the new fluid in the system. And what you'll need to do here is just gently pump the lever a little bit, and you can crack off the bleed nipple, release some of that fluid and air, and keep repeating that process until you've got a steady stream of fluid coming through with no air bubbles. As you do this, you'll feel the clutch lever start to come back, and hopefully you'll have a nice, smooth, not jerky action at the lever. A little bit lighter too with this slave cylinder. Have a bit of a clean up. Final check. And I like to spray a little bit of ACF50 afterwards. Just stops any corrosion, and while you're in there, gives you a chance to have a bit of a wipe up, get any spilled brake fluid out of the way before that does any damage, but also just check for any of the leaks and what have you while you're in there. So not a tricky job, around 15 minutes of effort, assuming you've got everything to hand. Looks nice, feels great at the lever. To torque that down. Three bolts, bleed nipple, and that banjo. And then we're good to go. Not a bad morning's work. Great part from RSR, and a nice simple task for a Sunday morning. Thanks for watching.